Bill and Linda.
Bill just looks young.
By the hair, too.
Barbara.
A November wedding.
L is for the way you look at me. O is for the
only one. We are here to help celebrate this momentous day in your married life, number 50. Wow, that is remarkable. Who would have guessed that between you two? But we know it's been many, many years of fun and glory. And we just want to share a few good memories where you guys were involved with us to celebrate this occasion.
We were asked, what is your very first, how did you meet Linda and Bill? Well, for me, Linda, you were walking down Birchwood Lane putting flyers in mailboxes for the Pebble Fork Lane party, and you were so welcoming and said, we have to come. So guess what? We came. And it was really a blast to meet you and your neighbors. And I do remember quickly that you talking to me, I mentioned that Jim was an orthodontist, and I remember you putting your finger in your mouth and saying that you really wanted to talk to him about something. So there we go, all these years later.
And little did I know that I was to be looking into that mouth for a good long but successful orthodontic session that created and brought you a nice, beautiful smile.
So thank you very much for including us on all those great Lane parties. Number two, our favorite, Bill and Linda, go.
Well, any time with you two is always guaranteed excitement and guaranteed unexpected moments. Probably the most memorable one was when you came up to the director's big invitational, big event of the Club of the Year golf tournament, where Bill and I decided that we are going to put on our best show and possibly walk off with the top prize.
So day number one, both the guys played their best. It wasn't all that great, possibly. So Linda, you and I decided that we needed to make them what they are, as we know. So we went and found a place to make. We went up and found a place that we could have a trophy made for them. And it turned out to be one of the keepsakes of our lives, I think, with you two. I think you have it on your mantle. We have it on our mantle. The year that these two guys became the champions of everything.
Let me repeat, the champions of everything. Right on.
We love you guys. You are so much fun, and we hope for many more years of great stuff.
And may your future as well always include us.
Yeah. Okay.
Love you.
Good night.
Jack and Karen, and this is take number 76. We met Bill and Linda in Pasadena when Bill and I started there at Merrill Lynch. We became the best friends, and we were together there all the time. So that's how we met. I will tell you my story in just a second because my phone makes me do this in 20-second intervals. Take number 77. My best time, I think, was when we went to Mexico with Bill and Linda. We stayed there an entire week, and it was the best vacation I've ever had. We would send Bill out to get food, and he would come back with live fish that nobody recognized. But we'd clean them up, cook them up, and it was the best meals I think I've ever had. That was my favorite week of all time.
79, a story to follow. Young Sun Mark absolutely loved Bill, and when it came time to talk about his best friend, He was in kindergarten, and he said, well, of course, my best friend is Bill Dudley. I will always remember that, and it says what kind of people Bill and Linda are. We love you.
Hi, Bill and Linda. Happy anniversary from Pebble Fork in Northfield, Illinois.
Yep, we're together here, and just to wish you a happy anniversary, and remembering the times we moved in here in 1986 next door to you in Northfield, and a few months later ran into Bill and Linda after we briefly met them, and they said, hey, you guys, the kind of guys like to go out and see a movie and grab a burger and a beer, and we said, absolutely, and then we were off to the races with a long-lasting friendship that, and did so many things together through the years, between golfing with Bill, between we did Twilight Bowling, which was a riot, and we did surprise our wives on Mother's Day at a restaurant with poems, songs, jokes, and corsages. So many other things when we went to the dog track for Linda's birthday, and just a multitude of things over the years. So all together, we would just like to say happy, happy anniversary.
Hey, Linda. Hey, Bill. It's Paula and Lou wishing you a very happy 50th. Sorry that we can't be there to high-five or hug in person, but given the times, this is the best that can happen. Anyway, we are sending lots of love. Not as many good stories, but actually Paula is sending way more love than me. And the reason for that is that she's got a hideous eye infection, and that's why she's not in front of the camera, she's behind it, because she loves you too much to let you see her. But she'll say happy anniversary now as well.
Long friendship.
Paula, say happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary, you two. We love you. We're sorry we can't celebrate with you. We love having you as friends.
Anyway, we have many good memories, none of which is the best story of all. They're all great. And Reed had asked, well, when was the time, first time you met Linda and Bill? And Paul and I can't agree on that, funny enough. But at any rate, we love you. Congratulations and best wishes.
Well,
Hi, Bill. Hi, Linda.
Yes, we're thinking about you and hoping you're having a wonderful celebration with the family.
We're slightly disagreeing on when we first met. In your mind, it was something to do with Linda.
I was playing golf, I think, with you, Linda. And we were sitting in a golf cart and discussing where we lived. And Chicago came up, of course. And
that's how it started.
That's how it started.
I remember it differently.
The thing is, the thing that really surprised Linda was, I said, well, I had a group of friends, an international group, a small one, about six of us. And there was another English girl in it, Linda Harding. And she said, Linda Harding? You know Linda Harding? And it was so funny. And from then on, we saw them a lot.
It also turned out, transpired, that unbeknownst to any of us, we had been in Chicago or thereabouts for quite a few years and lived probably, 4 miles apart, if that. But, you know, we lived in different worlds, I guess. All I remember is the newcomers' dinners, which then led on, which was 99, to the 999ers, which, for that kind of a social group, had quite a long lifetime.
We saw a lot of them.
Yeah, we saw a lot of them.
The dinners and all the get-togethers, which
you know, people leave, people die, and all kinds of bad things like that. I remember particularly a couple of voyages together. One was starting on the Danube, going to the mine,
which
Rhine,
was a lot of fun.
Which was a lot of fun. A cruise boat full of Brits, actually, but they're all pretty civilized. And I also took Bill and Linda, or we did, to Oxford. for the inauguration of the new organ.
Mm-hmm.
And in the course of that, of course, we went to the library, which is the oldest in England. Saw some interesting stuff.
Which was really, yeah, very interesting.
The highlight, I think, was undoubtedly our all attending Eucharist, which in the Church of England is otherwise known as Holy Communion. It's one of the, I would say, most solemn rites of the Church. And of course, in the course of the communion itself, Bill went up. I hadn't realized he was a member of the Church. I'm not sure he is, but anyway, went up there. And became the first person in 750 years to ask the celebrant how he was doing today. We should laugh about that. But apart from that, I think, of course, our social life has been messed about by COVID. But that's ending. I think we managed to get Bill and Linda out last week.
We've been out together.
And we will survive.
Shortly after.
But let's finish up by saying that we wish you our best for the future and many congratulations on staying married for 50 years. For which Linda in particular deserves a medal. Thank you very much.
Lots of love and cheers.
Cheers.
So are they paying us by the hour to do this?
They're not paying us at all.
Well, let's keep it short, okay?
Okay.
Hi, I'm Don Loft.
I'm Susan.
We started coming to the lake about 16 years ago on the weekends and moved there full time about 10 years ago. I can't pinpoint a time that I actually met the Dudleys. They just seemed like they were always there. We always knew them. They were everywhere, and they were sort of the unofficial first couple of Reynolds. My first clear recollection of the Dudleys was at a fundraiser for the Dixie Cups. The money was to be used to fight breast cancer. Bill was the auctioneer, and of course he was glib and charming and entertaining, and I decided I needed to get to know that guy. Little did I know that Linda was actually way cooler. But we did get to know them, and we did a lot of things with them. Played golf with Bill, had about a million cocktails, a lot of wonderful dinners. They actually recruited us to prop up their sagging trivia team and return them to their former dominance, which we were more than happy to do.
Whenever there was something outside the mainstream to do, Linda and Bill were willing to go with us. That included a professional rodeo in Shady Dale. It included women's roller derby in Athens. It included professional bull riding in Atlanta. And they loved it all, we did too. They even got us addicted to going to the gymnastics at the University of Georgia. Now that we have moved to Atlanta, we don't get to see them as often, but we will never lose touch because we do FaceTime happy hours very often.
We have some important things in common with the Dudleys. Bill and I had to pretend to be grown-ups in order to succeed in our careers, but of course we never did really grow up. So therefore Susan and Linda had to supervise us and sort of raise us, which they did a reasonably good job at, I thought, considering what they had to work with. But our two couples never lost our curiosity about things and sort of natural sense of wonder and our desire to see and do new things. We made sure that when we were together, we laughed a lot. And also drank a fair amount, too.
I remember as a young child reading Reader's Digest every night. There was a section called Unforgettable Character. We have known a lot of amazing people, but Linda and Bill are certainly one of the most unforgettable couples.
So, Bill and Linda, here's to the next 50 anniversaries.
May they be as happy and interesting as the first 50.
We love you guys. Take care.
Hi. Happy anniversary from across the miles, across the country. We wish you a happy 50th anniversary, but we're here to tell stories about you. We've known Linda and Bill forever. In fact, we're family. I'm Linda's sister, Barbara.
Yeah, and I'm Mike.
And our memories go way, 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 way back. Remember the Rose Bowl parade?
Oh, yeah, the Rose Bowl in 1973. Jim Plunkett.
Of course, we missed the end of the game because we were looking for each other, but we better not tell that story.
No, I can't tell that story.
We can tell stories about traveling. Linda and Bill are our very favorite traveling companions, and we have a lot of good stories there. Like, there's the one in Prague when you and Bill bought absinthe.
No, we can't tell that story.
Oh, yeah.
No, well, the good news is, though, they've now legalized absinthe in this country.
Let's see. How about the time we were sailing in Greece? Remember the time when Bill...
Oh, no, we can't tell that story.
Oh, okay. Let's see. How about, I know, in Portugal, when Bill was learning Portuguese.
Right. Yeah. That was a good one. He got good at Portuguese.
Yeah, Hakuna Matata, baby.
Yeah, is that the same place where the lady is still trying to chase us for stealing the lemon?
No, that was in Spain.
No, we can't tell that story either.
No, we can't tell that one either. Let's see. There's this story. Oh, my gosh. Like I said, there's so many really good stories. Boca Raton, should we tell that story?
No, that would be embarrassing.
Okay.
How about Kenya?
Oh, when Bill learned Swahili?
he got it again.
We got one good thing from Kenya we can tell, and that is we're not just relatives, we're Rafiki, and that's Swahili for friends. So I think that's sort of important. We came, fabulous trip, by the way. How about this story in England? Should we tell the story about in England about when we were at the hotel?
Oh, no. You can't tell that story.
Gosh. Nova Scotia. Nope, can't tell that story. Well, as you can see, we're chock full of a lot of good stories, but they're sort of like what happens in Portugal
stays in Portugal.
And what happens in Nova Scotia
stays in Nova Scotia. As a matter of fact, we went to Las Vegas with them too. And what stays in Las Vegas definitely stays in Las Vegas.
So those are all our stories mixed into one because they're really good to share. And sometime if you're interested, just let us know and we'll give you all the good stuff. But in the meantime, 50 years really is a major accomplishment. And congratulations, you guys.
Yep, congratulations.
Happy anniversary.
Bye.
Hey, Bill and Linda. Happy 50th anniversary.
50 years, that's quite an accomplishment. Linda, you are very patient, and Bill, you are very lucky. Now, I first met Bill at rehearsals for On Golden Pond. I was walking up the aisle on my first night there, and Bill was already on the stage, and he was dressed pretty normally, except he had on red socks. And I thought, well, this is going to be fun. And it was.
Well, for many years, Bill and I have been involved in a golf group called the B3s, three or four foursomes to play once a week. We're all supposed to invent a game and take care of making the tee times. Bill's famous for either not showing up when he makes the tee times or not inventing the game when he comes.
Okay, and now Linda, I want to address you. One of the things that I just love about you, you're so creative and you dug out these art supplies that you hadn't touched since you were in high school, and now all of a sudden, not all of a sudden, but you're winning all kinds of awards and blue ribbons.
And one of the best things I love about you, Linda, is you always make me cookies for dessert, and you have the best snack closet in anybody's house that I've ever been to.
So guys, happy anniversary. We hope you have a wonderful day.
Have a great memory. Bye-bye.
Hi, everyone. This is Donna and Jim Stanton. We first met Linda and Bill in the late 90s here at Reynolds. We've had many, many great times with them over the years. Our favorite memory is watching seasons of American Idol with the Dudleys, the Weirs, and the Olivers. The eight of us met weekly, taking turns hosting the events. We called ourselves, appropriately enough, the Idol Minds. We compared our diverse ratings to the contestants with the American Idol judges. And we had a huge differences of opinion, to say the least, which became very, very loud at times. Someone would like to say something.
And I'd like to say that one of my best memories is watching Linda and Bill dance. The way they looked into their eyes, you could just see there was so much love. And I'd also like to congratulate them on all of their wonderful accomplishments. Best of all, the best accomplishment are their children and their grands. So we wish them the best of luck and
50 years of wedded bliss. We love you guys and hope to see you soon. Take care.
Bill and Linda, congratulations on your 50th wedding anniversary. I've always heard that time flies, but this is ridiculous. It seems like just last month we met, but it was 41 years ago. Unbelievable. We were asked to tell how we met you and to give our favorite memory. I hesitate to tell my stories because one, they're too long. Two, you've heard me tell them many times before. And three, your memory of events might be different than mine. But here we go. I'll give you the Reader's Digest version. I met Bill in December 1979. His firm, Payne Weber, had bought my firm, and there was a get-together cocktail party. I was in the drink line when Bill cut in front of me. I let him know in very colorful language where the end of the line was. He then looked at me, put his arm around my shoulder, and said, "Bartender, get this man and all his friends, anything they want, anything, and put it on my bill." I burst into laughter. Of course, it was an open bar and the drinks were for free. Bill and I spent a little bit of time at the bar, had a couple drinks together. During that conversation, he offered me the opportunity to move to Chicago and to work for him on the Chicago Mercantile Exchange. I immediately accepted. Within a few days, I'd moved to Chicago. Bill and I quickly became fast friends. At the end of the day, we would often go out for a few beers. During one of these sessions, he suggested that I get my girlfriend and that we go out to dinner with he and Linda. I'd never met Linda. I thought this was a great idea. I accepted. Well, I had beers at the bar with Bill, and then I had beers on the train on the way home, and then I had beers at dinner. I was way overserved. As the evening went on.
Hi, Linda and Bill. I had a buzzing in my ear that you were celebrating your 50th wedding anniversary. Has it really been 50 years since we gathered in upstate New York? Wow, I guess it has. I want to offer a warm and heartfelt congratulations. I'm very happy for the both of you. I was asked to share my thoughts about first meeting both of you, and I will get to that shortly. But first, I want to make a few comments about how lucky you are, Bill. No, this is not going to be about Linda. It's about South Korea. Apparently, you forgot that a 10-year-old kid gave you his lucky wooden nickel for good luck a few days before you headed off to Vietnam to fight in a war. But while in transit, your assignment was changed to a desk job in South Korea. One would think that might have made an impression on you, and that you might have kept that lucky wooden nickel, maybe framed it, maybe hung it on a wall. But no, it seems you actually don't remember it. Pretty big event, but apparently it made no impression. So what made impression on my brother? Yep, that's Linda. Linda made the impression. So let me move on to some stuff that is old, not as old, but pretty old. It was hard for me to come up with the first time I met Linda and Bill, since both of you have been around for such a very long time in my life. So when I have hard questions, I ask Shirley, and here's what she remembers about the first time that she was going to meet you. I was working at Exxon in Century City. She was attending UCLA. You guys lived in posh and trendy Huntington Harbor, and Bill was a hotshot executive with Merrill Lynch. We invited you over for dinner one weekend in 1975 or so. As Shirley had never met you, she wanted to make a good impression and decided to make her mom's world-famous country-style pork chops. She was slaving away in the kitchen all afternoon, and as evening approached, Linda called to give us the heads up that Bill was running late. "Thanks, no problem," I said. Shirley toiled on in the kitchen, and over the next 3 hours, Linda called three more times. "Sorry, Rich, your brother is still late." "Thanks, no problem." The country-style pork chops turned from a delicacy to dried-out cardboard, to burned beyond recognition, and finally carbonized chunks. They were totally inedible. So what does Shirley remember about the first time she almost met Linda and Bill? After your no-show, she thought Linda was very considerate for keeping us updated over those many hours of Bill missing in action, and she could not understand how Linda put up with him. As I connect the dots, I think the two of you are still together because Linda has unbelievable patience for some of the things that Bill does. And from that, I conclude that raising Brad and Reed must have been a snap after raising Bill. So once again, congratulations on the 50th anniversary. I hope you have a wonderful time with your family. And Bill, here we go. Go Dodgers. I hope they did it this year. Let's hope so. Thank you to Reed and Lauren for putting this together and offering me the opportunity to say congratulations. Bye-bye, guys. Have a great time.
What's going on in there?
Oh, hold on. Let me finish up this Zoom call. Hey, I'm gonna call you back. All right, just send an email. But I have a feeling I know why you're here, and that's not to join me in these lovely suds. It's to talk about Bill and Linda and their 50th wedding anniversary, which is a very, very exciting event coming up here soon. And I was thinking about a couple examples of the two of them together, and one that popped up to me, because it's obviously near and dear to my heart, is Reed's Marathon back in Chicago, gosh, almost 10 years ago. They were on the ground, hustling all over the place, tons of uncertainty, trying to figure it out in the cold. And it was just a great example of them helping each other and working together, which is really what a great and long-lasting marriage is all about. So I'm thrilled for both of you. I love you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you for everything that you've ever done for me, Reed, and the entire family. And honestly, let's get back to the jam.
I wanted to wish you both a happy anniversary. It's been 50 years. It's hard to imagine. But here we are 50 years later. There are a whole bunch of good stories that I could share, but I won't compete in the storytelling department. But I did want to send wishes along to a couple that I love, that I think are fun, funny, and the two of you are full of mischief. My life is richer because of you, because of knowing you. You are greatly loved. Your value is immeasurable. So congratulations and love to both of you. Happy anniversary.
I have known Linda since the day I was born because she's my sister. And I met Bill in the early days of their relationship when they started to date. And one of my favorite memories of Bill and his sister and brother were wrapping telephones, telephone books, hangers, everything else they could think of to put more presents under the Christmas tree so it looked like a great Christmas. And thought, okay, we're in for an absolute riot with this guy. Well, Linda ended up marrying him, and the wedding was so much fun. It was so sentimental. Linda got married in the same church my folks got married in. She wore my mom's wedding dress, and it was really a very, very beautiful day. So, as the years have gone by, one of my favorite memories of those two crazy people is meeting them in Breckenridge to go skiing. Bill's family would rent a condo or something for a week up there. So I would join them for a while. We went up and went skiing and we were racing up and down hills. Oh my gosh, it was so much fun. We would be exhausted at the end of the day and just always just going 100 miles an hour as fast as we could just to enjoy every second. So I don't have any crazy stories. Well, I do, but I can't put them on a video. Linda came to my rescue. I got taken off an airplane on an emergency basis. I had to have an appendectomy and stayed at their house for a recovery period. And Linda was a trooper, man. I'll tell you, she had to put up with me. Bill has always been like a big brother and tried to give great advice on business and on just life in general. Very level-headed, very pragmatic about the way he suggests that I do things. So they've been wonderful friends and wonderful family and lucky to know them. And I'm going to leave all the crazy stories to everybody else because there are so many. I just can't record that long. But we love you and love being with you and love all the time we get to spend with you over the years. I just don't know what else to say other than there is only one Linda and Bill, or Big L and the Boss. You got that. Bye.
Happy anniversary.
Oh my gosh, yes, I'll tell you what. 50 years, who knew that you're going to live this long without killing each other? Oh my gosh, you're both alive and here you are to celebrate 50 wonderful, I'm sure it was wonderful years. Although there's been a lot of ups and downs in everyone's life when they're married that long, here's the good news. You are on an upswing and can do nothing but celebrate this accomplishment. It's amazing.
Yeah, you know, I remember some really good games of Croft. Some of them were pretty close, and I think we've got a lot more coming in front of us.
Bill always cheats.
I didn't say that, Bill. So the other thing we wanted to chat about is just, it just seems like yesterday when we were down there for sitting in the jury box at the play, that was so much fun.
And lots of memories from you guys being in college and starting your college careers. Oh yeah, remember these folks? Uh-huh. Your red solo cups. You had a couple nights with these. Some toga parties and just a lot of different things. And then on to your gorgeous wedding in upstate New York, which, by the way, commemorates the drunkest I've ever been in my entire life. And it was a lot of fun. And so as the years have gone on, you know, every marriage that lasts this long has many, many ups and downs. And there's just no way you get through it without those highs and lows. But you guys have weathered the storm and you've come out at a 50-year wonderful benchmark of saying, look at the family you've built, look at the memories you've built. And we're just so happy for you. And it seems like both of you, between Senior Olympics and your artwork and doing plays, you're just enjoying your senior years to the absolute max. So, oh, I know. I remember one. Remember, well, Jessica and I drove over to Stanford to see Bill in the Senior Olympics. And so I sat with Linda, and we were watching and cheering him on. And as we were walking to another event, Bill reaches over and puts his arm around Jessica and says, Jessica, remember, you don't need boyfriends. They only want one thing. Just remember, boys only want one thing. Don't fall for the I love you. That's not true. They want one thing. Well, that has lived in our family for years and years since your wonderful life advice. So some things live on. At any rate,
we wanted to offer a toast to you for 50 wonderful years. And so congratulations, 50 amazing years. And here's a toast to you, Big L and Boss.
Yep, we love you guys and hope that you have a wonderful time celebrating. Wish we could be there in person, but this is the next best thing. Sending you love, hugs, and here's to you.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Actually, I'm calling to tell you about something that I'm worried about. Your daughter, Reed, contacted me, and she's spreading rumors that you're having a 50th wedding anniversary. Is there something that went wrong? that she would do this to you? Well, anyway, I guess I'm supposed to tell you that I remember things about you that I've tried to forget, I guess, but they're still in my head. So anyway, Bud, I met you at Payne Weber Jackson and Curtis back in 1970, and along with Gary Segwe. And by the way, sidebar, Gary Segwe says one word about me that isn't completely flattering. Remove it from the video and tell me. Then I met Linda shortly thereafter at a party at your home. And there was a gentleman, I don't recall who he was, but he was smoking a cigarette inside. And that was the first person to do such a thing and be told by a woman to stop it and get to the porch. Love that about Linda. She doesn't take any prisoners. So I'm here to wish you a happy 25th wedding anniversary. I'm also here to be a character witness if you need a police report against your children. Tell Bud Jr. he can now get a cell phone and get off that great big red plastic phone that you took the photo of when he was 2 and kept on your desk until he was 19 or 20. That was just wrong. No wonder they're doing this to you. So if it really is your 25th wedding anniversary, because that's about how old I tell people I am, I wish you a happy anniversary. I am honored to have you as my friends for such a long time. And I'll be down to see you soon. No, I won't. But the threat is always there. Have a wonderful, wonderful wedding anniversary, whatever, 50, 70, I don't recall, 100 years, I don't remember. And let me think, do you have any closing remarks? Buy low, sell high. Bye-bye.
Happy 50th anniversary, Mom and Dad. You know, some of my best memories growing up were watching you guys get all dressed up for Dad's work events or for charity events and going to these black tie functions looking so glamorous. And I always thought how much fun it would be when I grew up and got married and was able to dress up and do stuff like that with my husband. Well, for the record, Aaron and I have been together 12 years and we have not yet once gone to an event where I can get dressed up. So I thought I would dust off this dress and wear it for your anniversary video. You know, my first story about you guys is not a memory because I wasn't born yet, but it's a favorite story. You guys were just dating in New York, and this is a story about how my mom got her emeralds. She, before they could afford it, they would walk down the street in New York past Tiffany's and look in the window and see this specific jewelry set. And every time they'd say, oh, you know what, when we get these, we'll get the emeralds to go in the settings. And then the next day they'd say, no, the rubies. And so it was kind of just something that they would do on their walks. But then years later, when my dad could afford it, he actually got that set of jewelry designed with emeralds and gave it to my mom. But that is one of my favorite stories of their marriage. So, but some of my best memories of you guys all have one thing in common, and that is that you always had so much fun in your marriage. There was always dancing in the kitchen. You would drop us off at summer camp every year and do a couples trip. The first one was that bike trip through France. There was the surprise 40th birthday for my mom where my dad got the bus, the school bus, and it said, Linda's going to the dogs on the side. And of course, all the costume parties. I love that you guys still to this day really know how to rock a costume. From the, of course, the favorite is the Gaddafi costume with the bullet hole in his head. And if that ever gets back to the Junior League in Chicago, I'm sure that you're going to get kicked out if you have not gotten kicked out already. But the best memory of your marriage is truly that you made it work through all the ups and downs. When we were younger, your strong marriage gave us stability at home when many of our friends didn't have that with their parents. And by making it work for 50 years, you have given Brad and myself the example of what a successful marriage looks like. So congratulations on 50 years of marriage. I love you.
I remember Brad and I's wedding weekend. We were having brunch the next day and I look over and I see this. Both of you just walking away, so in love still. And I just kept thinking to myself, I really hope that Brad and I are that in love after 50 years of being married. And not just the love that you have for each other, but the love that you have for everybody around you. Putting together this video has been so eye-opening because it just speaks volumes to who you are as people and as a couple and how many people love you and have so many great stories and memories to share about you. And also just looking back at all the places that you've traveled together. I know this has been a tough year, but I hope you can remember that. And I'm just so lucky. I really hit the jackpot with both of you as in-laws, and I can't wait to celebrate together in person. I love you, and here's to 50 more years.
Hi, Mom and Dad. Happy 50th anniversary. Wanted to take the time to wish you both congratulations and talk a little bit about what your marriage has meant to me personally. In that I think about it a lot in terms of my life and my relationship with Lauren. Me and Lauren are, as you know, very different people, but we work well together. And I think a lot of that is successful because of your mom and dad's, your guys' example that you gave on how two people that are very different can work together and work together so well that it lasts 50 plus 60, 70 years, whatever the future may hold. We all know that mom and dad are different because mom, as I've said before, was the disciplinarian and dad was more of the jokester. But I don't think that gives true merit to what those, to the differences in that maybe mom, you might see that as a negative, and dad, you might as well. But in reality, there's so much nuance in there that makes the marriage between you two wonderful for me being your son growing up. Like, mom, yes, was the disciplinarian, but what with that was a belief and a trust and a confidence in her son. She drove me an hour every day to go to Worlds of Wisdom and Wonder, which I remember vividly. She created a program in school called LA Enrichment, Language Arts Enrichment, which I participated in. And she put me in fourth level English and as a junior. So that discipline went hand in hand with that confidence and belief that still resonates with me today. And dad, yes, dad was a funny jokester type character, but you know, what came with that was experience. I would remember gaining an appreciation for analytics, playing pirates and submarines in the basement. That was fun to do, but it also embedded a passion in me that has pushed me in a certain direction in my career. And I remember dad would have a company Christmas party or annual party for Kidder Peabody where they'd play tennis ball Scrabble and croquet golf, which was Krolf. And I remember dad saying to me, Brad, nobody wants to have another cocktail party. Have a fun time and don't take yourself too seriously. And people tell me that to this day. It had a delible imprint on me that still resonates with who I am as a person. So those labels come with a bunch of nuances that work together as you work together. And one of my favorite memories that was emblematic of this was we were coming home from medieval times, and dad was driving, mom was in passenger seat, and dad kept putting the quarters for the toll in his ear, and mom was yelling at him, Bill, 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 to it, which is a phrase me and Reed still say to this day, is the way mom would yell at Bill. But it was a memory of how you two worked together to create memories for me and Reed that were unforgettable. And if imitation is the purest form of flattery, then as I look at my life and where I'm going with my marriage and parenthood, emulating your relationship is certainly something that is true. You know, how do I know when is old enough for CJ to watch an R-rated movie? Well, I know it can't be sooner than third grade because that's when dad allowed me to watch Rambo First Blood Part 2 when I broke my arm. How do I know when is a old enough for CJ to get a pair of $100 sunglasses. Well, not before seventh grade, because that's when mom finally relented and bought a pair of Oakley Frogskins for a Christmas present for me. Now, these are milestones that I remember that I am going to embed directly into how I raise CJ. How important is school? What should I do when it comes to her scholastics? Well, not so important that I'm not going to remember to put CJ on the B train, on the Skokie Swift to go watch the Cubs, or in our case, the Orioles. When it comes to music, what influence will I have? Well, I'm going to find a Mexican restaurant, and on the way there, we're going to listen to Billy Joel, Innocent Man, and we're going to play Password when we're there, just like we did at Los Magais. And on the way back, we're going to listen to Madonna, Lucky Star. And if I ever get in the position where I'm lucky enough to get box seats to a Broadway show, you better believe that it won't be me and Lauren sitting there. It'll be my kids sitting there, because in 1989, when Phantom of the Opera came to town, I remember every minute of that experience, and it still resonates to me with this day as what a wonderful memory. And it wouldn't have been possible without you both as parents. When it came to buying this house, even, I knew that one of the reasons we bought it was there's a pool nearby, a club that where our kids will belong to, and they have a place to grill out. You might not think I remember the Deb Keys, but I absolutely remember going and grilling burgers at dinner after a day's a pool at the Old Willow Club. It's influenced every part of my life and my decisions in my marriage and how I'm going to parent, and is a testament to how wonderful the 50 years of marriage between you both have been. The memory, I think, when it comes to love, that always has made an indelible impression on me is 1 year when you both came back from London on one of your trips where you went together as a married couple without kids. You had come home from London, you had brought home presents from London and showed them to me. And I had asked Dad, I think, first. Dad, who do you love the most? And Dad said, I love your mom the most. And I was a little taken back. Well, what about me? I love you and Reed equally, but your mom is the most important person to me in this world. And then, not happy with that answer, I went to mom and I asked her the same question. And you know what she said? She said, I love your dad the most. And I love you and Reed equally, but your dad is the most important person to me in this world. And that message of what it means to have a strong relationship where you put your partner first and you have the confidence to tell that to your kid, who your kid is thinking you're going to say him, is the most powerful message of what love means in a marriage. And one I can only hope to replicate to the best of my ability. Happy 50th anniversary. I'm sorry for all the tears, but I didn't think that would happen. But in any event, happy 50th anniversary, Mom. You've set Mom and Dad, you've set a great example, and one I can only hope to live up to and emulate to the best of my abilities, because the example you have set is one I want to recreate in my own life. Congratulations.
Anniversary video in 3, 2, 1.
Happy anniversary, Mom and Dad. I just wanted to spend...
Anniversary video in 3, 2...
Hold on.
Anniversary video in 3, 2, 1.
Remember that time you gave me the martini recipe book for Christmas and our family just got wasted and we never made it to dinner? Cheers.
I'm not comfortable with this.
Oh, shit. Thank God that...
2, 1.
Christmas was always a special time, so my favorite Christmas memory is the year that we put together gingerbread houses. Wait, wasn't that the year that the cat got into the gingerbread house and Mom drop-kicked him out of the house? Yeah, that definitely happened. It's okay, though. I know Boomer and Tigger felt well-loved. Wait, didn't you guys leave those cats in Northfield when you moved to North Carolina? What the hell, Mom?
My favorite Christmas memory of the Dudleys, I mean, there's so many, but the one that sticks out to me is we're all gathered together. They had the huge outdoor tree, and obviously we're on the horse farm. You know, a couple of the thoroughbreds were getting ready to run in the spring, and Mrs. Dudley made
Aaron, that is not our family. Is that your ex's family? Is that the Christmas you spent with your ex?
Oh, shit.
Oh, God, Aaron.
Then
you went
into like
3 minutes,
4 minutes, 5 minutes, 7 minutes.
Brad, we talked about this. You have to keep it to 3 minutes.
Come on. Whatever. I'm keeping it to what it is. I'm not, here's the thing about my stories. It's full of good stuff.
Christmas was always a really special time of year.
Oh, God.
Wrapped up in clover.